September. I will start by saying that I will be splitting my time with my colleague from Battle River Crowfoot, so I look forward to his comments at the conclusion of mine. Well, as indicated, this current debate is regarding the concurring report from the Foreign Affairs Committee, which condemns the imposition of sanctions by the government of China on the member for Wellington, Halton Hills. I'll start off by saying, Mr. Speaker, that I'm actually quite shocked that there was concurrence with this decision and with this report, because this certainly does not match the legacy of foreign affairs and foreign affairs strategy or lack thereof and direction from this government. And from the top, Mr. Speaker, it would seem that this concurrence report is about China. And yes, it certainly is about China. So let's talk about China for a moment. Their atrocities on Canada, Canadians, and the world. Of course, there's the horrible genocide of the Uyghurs. And it was the member for Wellington, Halton Hills, speaking up about this and taking a principled stand in the House, which earned him these sanctions. But in addition to that, Mr. Speaker, of course, we have more than 2 years, the arbitrary incarceration of Corrigan Spavor. So that's something certainly which we can be in just discussed regarding the People's Republic of China. In addition, of course, the banning of imports, in particular, the pulses that we saw, the terrible trickle-down effect that this had for our agriculture and for our farmers. But Canadians have not been alone, Mr. Speaker, in terms of the effects felt by China. Schellenberg remains on death row, of course. Taiwan has faced horror as its next door neighbor under constant threat. But my point here tonight, Mr. Speaker, isn't that. This concurrence report is not about China. This concurrence report is about the types of leaders in the world who are willing to stand up to the world's dictators and determine the direction that the world will go in. And, Mr. Speaker, there are two types of leaders. There is the member for Wellington, Halton Hills, who I will go back to, and there is, Mr. Speaker, the Prime Minister. The Prime Minister who has praised the dictatorship of China. The Prime Minister who wrote a tearful eulogy for the passing of one of the greatest dictators Latin America has known. For a Prime Minister who has donated more than $50 million to the Asia Infrastructure Bank to contribute to the Belt and Road Initiative around the world that keeps developing nations captive. That is one type of leader, Mr. Speaker, the Prime Minister that this world has. But it is not the type of leader that the world needs, Mr. Speaker. The type of leader that the world needs is the member for Wellington, Halton Hills, who said upon these sanctions that he would wear these sanctions like a badge of honor. He went further than that, Mr. Speaker. He said, he spoke in the House, "The sanctions imposed on me and others have brought us together. They have backfired. I have met with elected parliamentarians who have been sanctioned in the United Kingdom, the European Union, and members of national parliaments throughout Europe. The sanctions have brought us together and have brought us together in action. The sanctions imposed on me," he continued, "and others, are a clumsy effort by the People's Republic of China to silence the free speech and open debate at the heart of liberal democracies. They will work if we are silent, and we cannot be silent. We cannot lose the hard-won and hard-fought for ideas that underpin our democracies. A belief in liberty and freedom, a belief in human rights, a belief in democratic institutions, and a belief in the rule of law. For if we are silent, we will let these hard-won and cherished beliefs be lost to a new ascendant model of authoritarianism, repression, and fear," Mr. Speaker. And, Mr. Speaker, I will add that the member for Wellington, Halton Hills, was in good company in the last administration of the Canadian government with Harper, with John Baird, with my predecessor in Calgary, Mindaport, Jason Kenney, because they were a government that were governed by the values of democracy, the rule of law, human rights, all of these things which have been lost by the current government, Mr. Speaker. So, Mr. Speaker, I am pleased to see concurrence of this report, but really this report and this concurrence, Mr. Speaker, is not about China. It is about the types of leaders in the world who are willing to stand up for the values that will put the world forward. And one of those leaders, Mr. Speaker, is the member for Wellington, Halton Hills. Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker.